Hello students, in this video we are going to start unit 4 of real analysis. The syllabus for this unit is as follows. Function of several variables which contain linear transformation, derivatives in an open subset of Rn, chain rule, partial derivatives, derivatives of higher order and Taylor's theorem. So before starting with linear transformation, first we will discuss some basic definitions such as space Rn, vector space, then dimension, linearly independent set, linearly dependent set, and then we will move to linear transformation. So let's start with the preliminaries. So the first is space Rn. Then we have for each positive integer, say n, Rn is the set of all ordered n tuples. Like if x is the element of x, it will be like x1, x2 up to xn, where all these x1, x2, xn are real numbers. This is the elements of Rn, that is x, are called vectors or points. Now suppose if x, y are two vectors or points of Rn, then x will be say x1, x2 up to xn, and y will be y1, y2 up to say yn. Then we can define the addition of these two vectors as x plus y, say x1, x2 to xn plus y1, y2 up to yn. We will add the we will add these two vectors component wise. So therefore x1 plus y1, x2 plus y2 to so on xn plus yn. And if we have a scalar C belongs to R, that is a real scalar, then the scalar multiplication with this vector x will be C. The vector is x1, x2 up to xn. So this scalar C will get multiplied with each of these coordinates. So we get C x1, C x2 up to so on C xn. Then this number 1 and number 2, these make this Rn as a vector space. This is called a vector addition, and this is a scalar multiplication by a real number or a scalar C. These two operations make Rn into a vector space over the real field R. Then if these two operations make this Rn as a vector space, then we must have the null vector of Rn, or say zero vector. So the null vector or the zero vector for Rn is denoted by zero and represented as such. Likewise, it is represented likewise. So the next is vector space X. Now second is vector space X. This X subset of Rn is vector space if for two points, or we can say vectors belongs to X, we get first X plus Y belongs to X, and second CX belongs to X, where C is a scalar. And if these two operations, if these two conditions get satisfied, then we say that this X subset of Rn is a vector space, and we call the members of the vector space as vectors. The third one is linear combination. If we have vectors x1, x2 to say xk from Rn, and the same numbers of scalars as c1, c2 up to ck, then the vector which is the linear combination of say c1 x1 plus c2 x2 up to ck xk the vector formed by this linear combination of vectors. This belongs to Rn, and this whole term is called the linear combination of these vectors. The fourth one is span. Let S be the subset of Rn. Now if we take linear combinations, or we can say different linear combinations of the elements of S, and we collect it in a set, say A, that is A is the set of all linear combinations of elements of S, then this set A is said to be spanned by this set S. Then we say that the S is the span of A, or we can say that S spans A, and this A becomes the vector space. That is, we can conclude that every span is a vector space. Next one is independent vectors or independent set. A set, say x1, x2, up to xk, is independent if the linear combination of these vectors, that is c1, x1, up to ck, xk, is equals to 0, and this implies that all these scalars are equals to 0. And from this we also can conclude that no linearly independent set contains zero vector, because if it contains zero vector, it will contradict with this condition. So no linearly independent set contains zero vector. And if a set is not linearly independent, a set which is not linearly independent, it's called linearly dependent set. Next one is a basis of a vector space. A set B, which is a subset of vector space X, is called basis of vector space X if and only if this set B is linearly independent set, and second one, that B spans X, that is X is the collection of all the linear combination of the elements of B. If these two conditions are satisfied by a subset of X, say B, then B is called the basis of vector space X. Then what is the standard basis of Rn? The standard basis of Rn is denoted by the set of vectors E1, E2 up to En, where this Ei belongs to Rn, and Ei is like 0, 0 and 1 at the ith position. Like if E1 is there, we will have 1 in the first position and 0 at remaining position. Similarly, E2 will be like 1 at second position and 0 at remaining one. Similarly, En will be 0 at all other positions except at the nth position. Now if we consider a vector X belongs to Rn, then this vector X can be expressed as the linear combination of this basis vector. Say X is equals to x1, x2 up to xn. Then can be written as, say, x1 e1 plus x2 e2 up to xn en. So we get x1 e1 is 1 0 0 plus x2, it is 0, 1, 0 at all other remaining position, plus xn, 1 at nth position. Then this is x1, 0 at remaining position. We multiply by x2 with this vector e2, so we get 0, x2, 0, plus up to so on. Again we multiply by xn to this vector, we get 0 and xn at the nth position. Taking the vector addition, we get x1, x2 up to so on xn, which is x. So any vector of xn can be expressed as the linear combination of this basis vector. Next one is dimension of a vector space. The dimension of vector space is defined as the number of vectors in basis of the vector space X, and it is written as, say, dimension of X is equals to, say, suppose S. For Rn, the dimension of Rn is n, since the basis of Rn contain n elements. Now these are some results regarding the dimension of a vector space. First one is, a vector space X is spanned by a set of R vectors implies that dimension of X is less than R. We know that the basis spans X, that is the vector space, and also the number of elements of the basis is the dimension of X. Therefore, whenever a vector space X is spanned by the set of vectors, then the dimension of X will be less than or equal to the number of vectors in the spanning set. Second is, dimension of a vector space X is equal to n implies, first, a set B of n vectors in X spans X, and if and only if that B is independent. Now if the dimension of the vector space is n, it will have a basis and by definition of basis, we know that basis spans the vector space. Therefore, a set of B of n vectors in X spans X if and only if B is independent, and also we know that B is the linearly independent set. Second one is, if dimension of X is equals to n, implies that X has a basis and basis contains n vectors, because we know that dimension is the number of elements in the basis. Third one is, for 1 less than R less than n, and if this set y1, y2, yr is an independent set in X, then X has a basis containing this set. That is, this set will be the subset of the basis of vector space X. Now the next definition, or the first article of this unit, which is linear transformation. The linear transformation is a mapping, say T, from a vector space X to a vector space Y, and this mapping is called linear transformation if it satisfies this two conditions. The first one is, if T of X plus Y is equals to T of X plus T of Y for XY belongs to the vector space X, and the second is, T of CX is equals to C T of X for X belongs to the vector space X and scalar C. If these two conditions are satisfied, then we say that this mapping T from a vector space X to vector space Y is a linear transformation, and this T of X can be written as TX. Similarly, linear operator is a linear transformation, or we can say a mapping T from a vector space X into itself then this mapping or this linear transformation is called linear operator. That is a linear transformation of x into x is called linear operator, this LO. And this linear operator is invertible if this t is 1 1 and on 2. Then we can write t inverse tx is equals to x for all x belongs to the vector space x. Now next is the theorem, which states that let R be a positive integer if a vector space x is specified, that is spanned by a set of R vectors, then the dimension of x is less than or equal to R. Let's start with the proof. Let the vector space x is spanned by a set of R vectors as given. We have to prove that dimension of x is less than or equals to R. So let us assume that dimension of x is greater than R. Now as dimension of x is greater than R, we can imply that there is a vector space say x which contains linearly independent set Q, which is y1, y2, yr, yr plus 1, and which is spanned by a set S0 containing R vectors. Now suppose for 0 less than I less than R and a set Si constructed from S0 by replacing ith element by the element of this set Q, by element of Q without altering the span. The span should not be disturbed. Without alternating span. So as S0 is x1, x2 up to xr, so S1 will be obtained by replacing ith element. Therefore, here x1, x2, and we will replace this xr. Here the element before this xr will be xr minus 1, and we will replace this xr by y1. Similarly, in S2, we get x1, x2 up to xr minus 2, y1, y2. And up to so on, we get Si as x1, x2, up to so on xr minus I, y1, y2, up to yr. Now, since this Si spans x, let yi plus 1 belongs to x implies that this yi plus 1 is in span Si. That is, yi plus 1 belongs to the set x1, x2 up to so on xr minus I, y1, y2 up to yr. That is, there will exist scalars. Okay, there are scalars a1, a2 up to ai and b1, b2 up to b r -1 such that this yi plus 1 is equals to summation j from 1 to I aj yj plus summation k from 1 to r minus I bk xk is equals to 0. Now from this we can imply that minus 1 of yi plus 1 plus summation j from 1 to I aj yj plus summation k from 1 to r minus I bk xk equals to 0. Now if we take all of this bk from 1 to r I minus 1 0, that is if all bk are 0, then this linear independence of q, we know that the q was a linearly independent set, and therefore any linear combination of this elements of q, we will get the all these scalars 0. So if all bk's are 0, the linear independence of q gives all coefficients a1, a2 to ai to be equals to 0. So which contradicts that? Which contradicts to minus 1 not equals to 0. Therefore all bk's cannot be 0. Implies that all bk's cannot be 0. Now suppose that one of the bk is equals to 0, that is some vector xk belongs to S can be written as or is in linear combination of other members of the set SI union YI plus 1. Now as XK, this vector XK is in linear combination of the members of set SI union YI plus 1, we can remove this XK from this set and we will call the remaining set as SI plus 1. Now this set SI plus 1 spans the same set X which was spanned by SI. Therefore the properties of SI plus 1 and SI are same, just I plus 1 in place of I. Now starting with S0, we construct the sets S1, S2, SR, and this set, last set SR, consisting of the vectors Y1, Y2 up to so on YR. And our construction shows that this set SR spans X, but the set Q is Y1, Y2 up to YR, YR plus 1, and we have assumed that dimension of X is greater than R, which has implied that this Q is Li. And hence this yi plus 1 not being in the span of SI is a contradiction. Therefore our assumption is wrong, the dimension of X is greater than R is wrong, therefore dimension of X is less than or equals to R. Hence proof. In next video we will continue with some more theorems on dimensions and linear transformations. Thank you.